This is all fair play. This is fair play too. Like people, Emily comes on our chat, and some people make her blush. Like this is fair play.
It's like you're getting the band back together, and we get to hear Hogue use a cursey word. We encourage.
No, I don't know about that. Is that an obligation here? I am echoing.
I don't hear you echoing on my end. Hopefully the chat doesn't either. But is there still echo?
Let me see if I caught.
Yeah, I'm echoing.
You're echoing. I don't hear it on my end. Hold on. How about now?
Let me see. Nope. No, echo's gone.
Echo's gone.
Any echo here? No echo for me.
Good. Echo from Hogue. Okay, it might have been me. Echo's gone. Yay! I might have fucked it up. Oh my god! No, not you, Echo. Cancel. No, stop it! Now it's playing music. Damn it! It started playing Uptown Funk.
Entirely appropriate.
I don't know why. Sorry, y'all. It was a whiskey stream, and now you're here. It's so good to see everybody.
I think Rob's got one too here. So you know, I have tea.
I'll bring the wine, you bring the whiskey.
That's what I bring to the party.
And Runkle the Bailey brought the drunk white chick.
This is my niece's stress ball.
I was gonna say I have questions to steal a catchphrase.
It's my niece's stress ball. And at one point in time, I was listening to, I think, Elaine Redoff's interview, and I just needed something, and it was like within arm's reach, and I grabbed it and just started squeezing the heck out of it and like chat. And it just has sat in this office since then. And sometimes I just need to squeeze something.
This unicorn was sent to me from Octo. The chat knows Octo Warren, a friend of mine, but a lovely Lawnard made me when I got my silver play button. So, you know, I could have also
grabbed a sack boy.
It is the most amazing me.
I love it.
So with a gavel, man, and my rings and earrings.
I don't have a unicorn, but I can meet my branding requirements. I have a Mario.
Oh, that's fantastic.
Yeah.
So Runkle's like, I have alcohol and a dog.
Runkle
like,
has a sword.
That's right. You do have a sword.
I knew the sword was coming. I just knew it was coming.
We love the sword. But that's what she said, Miss Paris. That's what she said. Anyway,
okay, bring it in.
Hogue, we needed to talk to you.
I'm sorry, we have a co-counsel edition.
Oh, co-counsel.
Okay, hang on. Okay, so I don't know that this will fit on the... Oh my god.
Yes.
So
I'm going to die.
Rick.
I am going to die.
Thank you.
Everybody's right, just
in. Am I in the cool kids
club? How big is that unicorn?
Well, it's at least as big as my daughter. I think she's under just kind of like a cozy pillow. So yes, we have a number of large stuffies here.
Hogue wins.
Pokemons.
Yeah. Oh,
yeah.
I have Pokemon. You can't see my upper shelf, but there are multiple Pokemon on the upper shelf because we're nerds here. That's why we all get along so much. Now people are like, my kid wants one.
I have no idea where this came from. I'm sure I bought it at some point.
Yes, I'm sure that you did. It's so fluffy. I'm going to die. Chad, I love you.
What is the origin of the giant unicorn, co-counsel?
It was a Christmas present.
Okay. Christmas present. From outside the family?
No, I got it.
All right. Co-counsel bought it.
Thank you, Sharon.
It's so fluffy.
Yes, they're doing all the "it's so fluffy I could die."
Oh, that's her for sure, and she's mad now and wants it back. So.
Oh, she wants it back. All right, well, say goodbye, everybody. The unicorn has to go back to my daughter's room.
I love that Hogue's family brought him a unicorn, and my family brought me whiskey. I mean, it's appropriate.
They want me to be participatory.
So amazing. I mean, it's appropriate. It's a good unicorn. I love it. So.
Thank you.
And my uncle gave me an axe.
I mean.
He passes out blades.
It's a very good gift. You're a woodworker. The axe is needed for the next time you need to break a bed.
Can we talk about the leather work here? Like, yes. That's how talented our friends are. Like,
yes. I'm not that talented.
Ian's kicking butt.
Rob, sweetheart, go hug your unicorn from Lawnard Down Under. I saw the chat also asking for Wood Daddy merch, but I didn't. I don't think I brought any of those up. America, Erica,
partner,
Jane's
my law partner vetoed that.
It's kind of fair.
I'll trademark that. I'll make Wood Daddy shirts.
You're Leather Daddy. Don't start. We've got Leather Daddy.
Do not give him that name. Do not give him that name. That is so much worse.
I'm getting out of this chat before I get a nickname.
Chat, do not Google that.
It's
why did you give me a reason to watch freaking Housewives?
Rob, like, okay, we're in the
wait, Rob,
I'm
Rob,
like,
Rob.
Emily has almost convinced me to turn this show on.
Rob, sweet, wait, did you guys don't know? Late law nerds, let me know in the chat with a one if I should tell Hoag and Rob and Runkle what Sweet James got for his birthday from Noella, either their birthday or their wedding, the stack. Do I tell them about the stack? Put one in the chat. If the chat votes, I'll tell you what lawyer Sweet James got for his birthday.
I don't have to look at the chat. I know what they're saying.
Wife, that his ex-wife shared on national television.
She
imagine
didn't even give him an option to say no.
I know.
Well, you could put a two
say,
for no.
She didn't say you could put two. She just said put one.
You could put a two. You could put a two in the chat. You guys can watch the chat go.
I don't have to watch the chat. I know the chat. Look at this. This is almost like a million ones. I got to tell you, it's a mysterious kind of teaser you gave there. I don't know what a stack is.
The chat knows what Sweet James got for his birthday. But here's the thing. This is a well-known kind of DUI type attorney in California. Billboards all over the place. His now ex-wife goes on TV and as they are getting divorced is talking all about their life and shares that the gift that she gave him was a stack of vaginas. And she has a picture of the three women stacked together for his, I think it was their wedding, but it could have been their birthday.
Yep. That was not how I imagined that sentence would end.
I have to say,
I didn't see the start of that coming. I didn't see the middle of that coming. I didn't see the end of that coming.
This is what's happening on Real Housewives. Like, imagine what your partners at a law firm would do if they learned this of you because their wives are watching television. Imagine the conversation you're having at work the next day.
That's right. Rob already has enough trouble with the Wood Daddy conversations at work, okay?
The stack. There were pictures and everything. The chat is like...
The trip that I took with that story was I thought it was going to be something, you know, maybe a little bit interesting. And then you say what it is. And I said, oh, okay, artificial. No. I'm thinking it's an artificial stack. Then you say, and this is how the women were laid. And I'm like,
no,
Jesus Christ.
I'm building up the courage to say stack of vaginas.
Stack of vaginas.
There it goes. It was a stack of vaginas.
Nope. You can see that I said nothing of any specific reference.
It was a stack of vaginas.
This is why you watch Real Housewives. You can't make this up. I don't know how they know that these women are going to say shit like this on television, but she's just talking about, to be fair, she was one of the three. I think she was in the middle, but she showed her friends the photo on her phone while they were out at dinner. And she's like, no, I gave him a stack of vaginas. And then they showed the picture of the stack of vaginas. She's like, can you guess which one I am? And then had her friends guessing.
Second part of it, right? It's the personality that then goes and says, this is a great thing to talk about with picture evidence
on television.
Does your cat have any idea like what I've actually seen? Like, I'm a practicing divorce attorney. I have seen cheating footage. I have seen pictures. I have seen sexting. I have seen everything. I have seen a couple bring a third party into a house with a 3 and a 5-year-old that they're all raising as a polyamorous family. I have seen all of this stuff. And Emily Baker just got me to say a stack of vaginas on YouTube.
I'm going to have to find you the episode where the stack of vaginas first comes up so I can send it to you, because because it comes up before she knows she's getting divorced, because he bounces. Rob, I would love for you to break down how this happened, but he bounces jurisdictions. He leaves to Puerto Rico and then files for divorce in Puerto Rico, but they're in California.
When you start the sentence with, I would love for you to break down, you say he bounces after saying stack of vaginas. There were so many ways that was
Rob,
going.
Rob, you're in my head, man.
Not seeing jurisdictions.
I'm like, Emily, you can't say that.
The Real Housewives of Orange County are iconic, but it's a very interesting show, and they really air all of it more than maybe they should. And then when they end up in legal trouble, they're filing motions saying, but we don't want you using clips from the show in the trial. And they're like, oh, the fuck you don't.
It's the same thing with Amber Heard. Like, I would like you not to use the statement that I made at this press conference over here. Yep. Please don't use that.
Yep. Rob is like, I love Trials of the Century. And Emily's like, stacks. ladies, but it's
not
again,
what I was expecting to end the day.
This is a prominent attorney in Los Angeles that everyone knows now all of the, and I just don't understand, like Jen Shah, who's getting ready to go to trial. She's on film talking about her first assistant. He's working at the computer and she's like, go make me some more money. He's now pled and is turning on her and is going to testify against her at trial. Like, but it's on, she can't say, oh, we weren't that close. You're on camera with him working on the computer while you're feeding him a banana saying, keep making me some more money. Like, it's going to come up. There's nothing you can do.
You know what? I'm going to just leave feeding him a banana to the side. I was actually gonna say I have questions, but I don't.
You're just done.
No
more questions.
I think Rob needs 2 minutes. Rob still can't believe that's happened. Dry contacts, throw
stack of vaginas.
The dry contacts are different.
It's that we're fully within the zone of, like, I'm gonna wake up tomorrow and be like, did this happen?
We needed a lighter stream, and now I've gotten to look. When Hoag's like, oh my god, it's cute you cover Housewives, do you talk about like stuff they say on Twitter? No.
It's not that I wasn't trying to diminish it.
I don't think
it
would
have a limited amount of legal content, and now I'm finding that it has significantly more than I thought it did.
Yes, and if you branch out into other reality TV, it is truly unlimited.
I'm afraid that Twitter's gonna be trending like stack of vaginas.
I feel like you say that because you want that to be trending. Chat, Rob is asking for hashtag stack
what Rob
to be trending.
His own time is up to him.
Rob
right?
wants hashtag stack trending on Twitter, because I don't know if Twitter would let the full sentence out.
No way.
Trending with Wood Daddy.
Yes.
No. I will throw the unicorn. No.
What? At your camera?
Rob, there's a decent shot it would also be trending with Leather Daddy.
Yes, Leather Daddy and Wood Daddy together there at the bottom of the screen.
Oh, don't ever say that in the same sentence.
See, just because that's on this, you're messing up all of your people's other recommended videos.
Right. Maybe you guys should just go train. Oh, Wood Daddy Stack is a good one. You know, if we're going to, like, look, they got Tug's Tits. Tug's Tits got trending above the fucking NHL. So I'm just saying, hashtag Wood Daddy Stack. There's over 19,000 of you in the chat. I think you could get that trending.
God, chat, are you effing kidding me? Stack Daddy is trending at 13.
Oh, God.
What Stack Daddy is trending at 13? What powers do you have, Emily?
There are almost 20,000 people in here. I don't even know where Good Logic is. So far, number 16 on trending 13.
Hey. Well, that's fantastic. Rob, you're famous.
for what?
Well, I mean, it could have been Unicorn Wood Stack Daddy.
This is Tug's Tits all over again.
Oh. I mean, it makes sense.
It was at this moment that he knew he fucked up.
Oh, Woodstack Daddy's number 10 in trending.
There you go.
Yes. Oh, with only 1,000 tweets, we can do better than that.
We're using our Care Bear powers for a little bit different goals tonight. But yes, I think it's great. Look at that right there. Fantastic.
Wood Daddy Stack. All right. Wood Daddy Stack is what's happening.
You know you can get above the Mets game there, Rob. You got this.
I mean,
actually, I know a lot of Mets fans that I can really piss off if that happens.
Well, we're trending above Taylor Anderson. We're past Taylor Anderson.
If the chat gets that past the Mets, I will broadcast that shit. Like, I know so many Mets fans that need that. Like, just
they need a Wood Daddy Stack.
They need the Wood Daddy Stack.
Yeah, you're only a couple of bases from being right next to Elon Musk cancels Twitter deal. So you can really seal this. Big day. Big day for everybody.
I'm not going to recover. The trend, it's going up and trending. You guys are like, oh my God, it's happening.
Wow, Fetch is happening.
Fetch is happening, number 8.
There's nothing Rob can't do.
A few inches later.
We were just hanging out in chat, and then you were nice enough to invite us on. Yeah. And all
number five. Don't forget to screenshot it on the way up.
That's right.
Screenshot that shit, Wood Daddy.
Steve Bannon and Elon Musk.
That's just so much better.
What I like is, you know, the people that are going to interact.
You know what's really funny about that one is like this. There's actually some logic to it. And oh my God, you guys got to 4.
Yes. There's
logic to it because it's people go after people for like the bots and they say it's all bots. No, it's how the algorithms work. When something goes trending, it goes trending. It's not bots.
It's not bots.
A bunch of people doing stupid shit on a
live. At the same time. Time matters and volume matters.
Of the internet.
It is absolutely the definition of the internet, but the tweets are amazing. Thank you all.
I want you to get at some point to a place, Rob, where your lovely nickname is required to be explained by that poor Twitter person that has to write the little paragraph under when it gets too big. So they can explain Emily D. Baker coins nickname for Law and Lumber. People respond or whatever else they would write as the sentence for this.
Oh, you almost had it.
It's number 3 on trending.
Good.
Number 2.
Do you? We're trending above SmackDown, which is number 4 on trending.
We're above
the Orioles.
The only thing we're not above is crime drama. What is Tony Sirico? I have no clue.
Go ahead and screenshot the moment of Wood Daddy Stack.
But you know what's funny about this is I don't even care about the Wood Daddy Stack. I care about the fact that this is independent content creators that have a small section of the interwebs. And this just shows you the power that all of you guys have in the chat.
Yep.
It's not like a single person that does it. It's
the group.
It's a group. It's a big group. And you all get together and you guys get to go and do battle with the big boys and tell them. And you know what? There's a big portion of Twitter right now who's looking online going, what the fuck is this? And that's, you guys did that. You guys literally created a thing that no one understands. And I'm almost there. I'm almost there. People
down here think I'm crazy, but I don't care. Wait, are we number 1? Yeah! We are victorious, chat. I'm so excited I could pee.
There you go.
Number 1 trending Wood Daddy Stack.
You guys are freaking insane.
The Law Nerds are the greatest.
What the fuck is going on in here on this day?
Will you cover Wood Daddy Stack trending on Twitter, though?
You know, I might. I might have to, actually. It might be headline kind of news. And we'd break that down. We'd talk about what it means. We'd really try to get behind the scenes on Rob as an individual and why he's so interested in stacks of all kinds. Lumber,
stacks other. Of wood. Stacks of wood. It's that grain stack pattern. I'm pretty sure he talks about... I'm pretty sure he talks about how tightly packed the grain pattern
is. Rob loves a tightly packed stack. We know this. It's tight.
I'm going to die.
So we might have to cover that.
I'm pretty sure.
Virtuality After Dark.
Rob's died. I'm pretty sure that would be a perfect virtual legality after dark. We talked about hobbies a little bit. We know that Wood Daddy's hobby is woodworking and that Leather Daddy's hobby is leatherworking. But Hogue, what are your hobbies and can we use them against you?
I don't know. I honestly worry. But yeah, no, I mean, I think people know what I like. It's video games and movies and TV. And that's what I do on the channel. That's what I do when I actually have free time, which is increasingly sparingly. But that's, you know, that's you can come up with something, I'm sure.
Look, we can't take this so seriously.
Oh, Hogue, they got you.
Did they?
Gamer Daddy Stack.
Gamer Daddy. We've got to ask Miss Hogue. I'm sorry.
I wouldn't have actually thought that Rob would be the first person to show feet on his
channel. No, never Ian, give in, Ian, Rob.
Ian, no, Ian.
Never give in.
I did on accident.
What? Wait, do you have a WikiFeet page? Does Wood Daddy have a WikiFeet page? Chat. I need to know. Somebody said Hogue's hobby is actually daddying. So you can just call him Daddy yes. if you want.
Yeah. Daddy. Endless clips that are going to come out of this stream are just astounding.
That's where we've arrived, folks.
That's all, folks.